The previous video, Preparing the Piston for Motion, described preparing the piston for motion. This video will begin the case setup process for a spark-ignited engine with port fuel injection. You can use the case setup doc in Converge Studio to set up the numerical schemes, physical models, grid control options, and more for your simulation. Based on your type of case and the models and parameters you activate, Converge Studio will activate and deactivate additional dialog boxes, fields, and options to fully configure your simulation. When you finish working through the sections of the case setup doc, Converge Studio will validate the options you have selected to ensure the choices are valid. Finally, you'll export the input files, and Converge Studio will generate the input files in the appropriate format for the Converge solver. The case setup doc is usually on the right side of the screen. If it is hidden behind another doc, click on the case setup tab in the lower right corner of the screen to display this doc. If the case setup tab is not visible, go to the view menu and check case setup doc. In the case setup doc, click begin case setup to open the case setup module. In this module, you'll activate the relevant options and features for your simulation. In applications, you can control the simulation type. The crank angle based option is for engine simulations, requires engine specific parameters, and measures time in crank angle degrees. The time based option is for general flow simulations and measures time in seconds. For this example, check crank angle based. Click apply, and a pop-up window will ask if you wish to load default engine application values. Click Yes. Converge Studio automatically sets some of the case setup items for an IC engine simulation, such as numerical schemes, transient solver configuration, and more. In the case setup module, click on Materials and verify that gas simulation, global transport parameters, and reaction mechanism are checked. Check Parcel Simulation, and notice that Converge Studio automatically checks Species. Click Simulation Parameters and verify that Run Parameters, Simulation Time Parameters, and Solver Parameters are checked. Click Boundary Conditions and verify that Boundary is checked. Click Initial Conditions, verify that Regions and Initialization is checked, and check Events. Click Physical Models, verify that turbulence modeling is checked, and check spray modeling, combustion modeling, emissions modeling, and source/sink modeling. Click grid control, verify that base grid is checked, and check adaptive mesh refinement and fixed embedding. Click on output/post-processing and verify that post variable selection and output files are checked. Click done, and the selected options will populate the case setup doc. Converge Studio includes default values for many case setup parameters. Some of these parameters are appropriate for this engine simulation, and some will need to be changed. In the case setup doc, click on IC Engine. This dialog box contains essential engine parameters. For this particular example case, we will use the following values. In the cylinder bore field, enter 0.086 meters. In the cylinder stroke field, enter 0.09 meters. In the connecting rod length field, enter 0.18 meters. This case does not have a crank offset, so leave the crank offset as 0. Since we are simulating intake, we resolve the cylinder flow, and thus the initial swirl value does not matter. Do not change the values of the next two fields. Verify that the head position is 0, and in the crank speed field, enter 3000 RPM. In the References section, specify the three cylinder boundaries. Click on the Piston Surface ID drop-down menu and select the piston boundary. Select the liner and head boundaries, respectively, from the next two drop-down menus. When you select these three boundaries, Converge can initialize the velocity in the cylinder based on the crank speed. Note that you need to define regions before using the compression ratio tool, so we will return to this feature later in the video series. Click OK to close the IC Engine dialog box. The Materials section of the Case Setup module allows you to configure material properties, the reaction mechanism, and the species in the simulation. Click on Gas Simulation. Use the recommended defaults for gas simulation, including the Redlich-Quang equation of state. Click on the Gas Thermodynamic Data button. Converge reads gas thermodynamic data from a data file, such as therm.dat, that includes the chemical composition of each species and coefficients to calculate entropy, enthalpy, and specific heat capacity. Converge Studio includes thermodynamic data for some species by default. For this simulation, you need to supply additional thermodynamic data. Click Import Data from File. Select the therm.dat file in the SI8_engine_PFI_sage example case shipped with Converge Studio and click Import. Refer to the Converge manual for additional information on therm.dat files. Click OK to close this dialog box. Click on the Gas Transport Data button. When Mixture Average Diffusion is unchecked, use this dialog box to specify gas viscosity and conductivity data. One method is to import a gas.dat file. Alternatively, manually enter gas viscosity and conductivity for two temperatures and click Interpolate for Converge Studio to linearly interpolate viscosity and conductivity values between the two temperatures. In this case, Converge Studio is preloaded with the necessary gas data. Click OK to close the Gas Transport Data dialog box, and click OK again to close the Gas Simulation dialog box. Click on Parcel Simulation. This dialog box allows you to specify liquid properties for discrete Lagrangian parcels. Because this simulation has port fuel injection, we must use the Parcel Simulation dialog box to add the fuel spray species, isooctane. Click on the Predefined Liquids button to launch the Liquid Database dialog box. Converge Studio has some predefined liquids that you can add. Find IC8H18 on this list and click Add Selected. Converge Studio will then add isooctane and populate the Properties section of this dialog box with the properties of isooctane. Note that data for isooctane must be present in therm.dat. The therm.dat file contains only gas properties, but the isooctane will vaporize, so therm.dat must contain properties for gaseous isooctane. Click OK to close this dialog box. Click on Global Transport Parameters. This dialog box allows you to specify the turbulent Prandtl and Schmidt numbers. For this simulation, leave them as their default values. Click OK to close this dialog box. Click on Reaction Mechanism. In this dialog box, you can import a reaction mechanism file, for example, mech.dat, that lists gas phase elements, species, and reactions. Click the Import Data from File button. Select the mech.dat file that was included in the SI8 Sage PFI archive, and click Import. Converge Studio will import the reaction data and list the elements and species present. This case uses the GIA-PRF reaction mechanism, which contains 4 elements and 48 species. Each species in mech.dat must have corresponding thermodynamic properties in therm.dat. Click Check Properties to verify this. Click OK to close this dialog box. Click on Species. In this dialog box, you can define liquid, parcel, non-Newtonian, scalar, passive, non-transport passive, and solid species. You can define gas species if you wish, although typically this is done in materials reaction mechanism. The species you define in this dialog box must have property data. For this example, you do not need to add any additional gas species to the gas tab because the necessary species are included in mech.dat. Click on the parcel tab and click the plus button to add a new parcel species. In the parcel field you just created, begin typing IC8H18 and Converge Studio will recommend isooctane. Choose this option. Next, click on the passive tab. Click the plus button 4 times to add 4 passive fields. Click on one of these fields and enter a passive called intake with a Schmidt number of 0.78. Repeat this to add cylinder, exhaust, and NOx passives. Leave the Schmidt number as 0.78 for the rest of these passives. Click OK to close this dialog box. Click on Run Parameters. Because this is an IC engine simulation, the solver type will automatically set to transient. Note that in the Solver tab, you can use the No Hydrodynamic Solver simulation mode to check for errors in surface motion or mesh creation. Use the MISC tab to choose which transport equations to solve. You do not need to change any of these default parameters, so click OK to close this dialog box. Click on Simulation Time Parameters. In the General tab, enter -520 crank angle degrees in the Start Time field. In the End Time field, enter 120 crank angle degrees. The Use Variable Time Step Algorithm option is active to help accelerate the simulation where possible. Enter 5E-7, 1E-8, and 2.5E-5 seconds for the initial, minimum, and maximum time step values, respectively. The CFL limits below control the time step. The options in the MISC tab allow you to control load balancing and variable limits. You do not need to change the default values for this case, so click OK to close this dialog box. Click on Solver Parameters. In the PISO tab, specify parameters to control the PISO algorithm. In Convective Flux Scheme, enter parameters to control the flux limiters for various equations. In MISC, specify miscellaneous numerical parameters. In Equations, specify solver and preconditioner type, tolerance, and iteration counts for the transport equations. In one of the tabs, click Set Recommended Values to load the default values for an engine simulation in all tabs. Click OK to close this dialog box. The next video, Case Setup Part 2, will continue the case setup process.